This is the appointed time. We have a quorum, so I call this meeting to order. Item 1. Election of a deputy chair. Members. Before the end of the nomination period, the Secretariat received only one valid nomination for the position of a deputy chair. The member so nominated is Ms. Lam So Wai. She's been nominated by Ms. Judy Chan and seconded by Mr. Gary Zhang. In accordance with Appendix 4 of the House Rules, if a valid nomination has been received for deputy chair, members can then decide whether there is a need to elect a deputy chair. Do we agree? Also, according to the House Rules, it has been decided that the subcommittee will elect a deputy chair. As only one valid nomination has been received, I declare that Ms. Lam So Wai has been returned deputy chair of the subcommittee. Congratulations. Item 2, applications for late membership. Mr. Chung-hung and Mr. Tang Ka-piu wrote a joint letter to the Secretariat dated the 16th of May 2023 applying for late membership. It's been issued under CB bracket 2452/2023/01. According to the House Rules, late application for late membership should be considered and decided by the subcommittee. So members, do we agree to allow the two of them to join the subcommittee, Ms. Michael and Bill? Welcome. Item 3. Dates or schedule of meetings and items for discussions. Members are free to make suggestions on items for discussion. Please refer to the terms of reference and the work plan of the subcommittee. Members, if you want to make any comment, please press the button and request to speak. Dr. Tik Chi Yun. I'll give each member 3 to 5 minutes. Thank you, Chair. I don't have strong views on the terms of reference. We have a wide enough scope in place, but I do have some thoughts on how we should plan this out. At the end of the year, the policy address will be delivered. And if we're able to come up with concrete suggestions in our subcommittee's report for implementation in the policy address, it would be ideal. Basically, this subcommittee will run for 12 months. If we're only able to float ideas at the end of our term, the recommendations will need to wait for the next policy address. I think there is urgency in the subcommittee's suggestions. I think there are 3 points that are rather important. I think priority should be accorded to these 3 points so as to strive for earlier implementation in the policy address. The first point is on definition. As the matter stands, the definition is too narrow in scope. The parents of SEN children are not covered. So we should, first of all, include them in this definition so as to provide them with support. Second point, in relation to support for carers, we have a 10,000 place scheme, but we have far more carers than the places allowed. This is just a drop in the ocean. We should strive for more places to be made available. Third point about daycare service. We've seen a number of tragedies because the carers did not have enough support. Now we have the 24-hour hotline. We also have information available on the internet, but these are not irrelevant to service provision, because once you disseminate information, There'll be a surge in demand. We need to increase service provision to cope with demand. These are the three major points which I hope can be included in the policy address. We should be able to work on these three fronts, and I agree with the rest of the points here. I'll give a response to what you said. You mentioned the two points, points 2 and 7, set out as part of our work plan in the appendix. As for financial assistance, perhaps we can include them in our work plan as well. Whether we can deliver the report in time before the policy address depends on our progress and the response of the administration. I will talk to the administration and give members a response in due course. Ms. Lillian Kwok. Thank you, Chairman. The work plan is quite comprehensive, but I have the suggestion. Can we invite carer groups to come and express their views? Can we hold a public hearing for their benefit so that we can listen to them and discuss their views? Second, apart from the definition of carers, I think we can add another point, and that is the different categories of carers. These carers look after different people with different needs. So instead of taking an across-the-board approach, we should look at the specific needs of these carers. Point number three, as mentioned by Dr. Tik Chi Yun, we should consider providing financial assistance. Now, we consider financial assistance from the perspective of rehabilitation. Apart from beneficiaries, we should also consider the financial circumstances of the households. And that means we need to collect statistics. That's one suggestion. Point number four, about the support hotline. Well, I think psychological counseling should also be provided. We are providing financial help, but at the end of the day, they still have emotional needs. And very often, tragedies are a result of the emotional problems. We need to provide them with support. About parents of SEN children and about support for carers in schools, we can enlist the support of organizations. We can set up a separate item, but at the same time, we can enlist the support of organizations to provide help for these carers. Right? We can go back and consider enriching our work plan. We already have a long list here. We have a rather tight time frame. So at the end of the day, we'll need to discuss with the Secretariat as well as the administration, together with Deputy Chair, of course, Ms. Lam So Wai, on prioritizing these points. Please, if I may, I think we can combine a number of points, such as points 2 and 6. I think these two are related, as well as points 8 and 9. I think these can be combined. We can first look at the overseas experience in terms of policies for carers. As a start, Ms. Doreen Kong, I have a suggestion on the proposed framework. In other places around the world, in 2013 in Ontario, Canada, there was a strategic blueprint for carers. In fact, this information is available online. It was published in 2013. The merits of this blueprint is that there are three broad categories of policy initiatives, and they set out the work plan in detail under these three broad categories. So that's just for our reference if we want to go into the specific. About work plan, points 1, 3, 10, measures to review the existing policies and the overseas policies. So I think points 1 3 10 can come under the category background. There are other points relating to our recognition of carers, our assistance given to carers, public education. So again, they follow the same logic. We can also make reference to other places. There are also different forms of assistance, say in terms of employment support. I think we can include that as well. Mr. Bill Tang and Mr. Michael Look are very familiar with these things about direct or indirect financial assistance. We can consider these as well. Points 5 to 9, I believe they relate to the same category, assistance on financial and employment support. Again, we can make reference to other countries' experience. The other point is, as mentioned by others, I do hope that we can hold a public hearing to listen to the views of carer organizations. Another member already made this suggestion. I will work out a plan with the Secretariat so as to heed the views of different stakeholders for the purpose of the work of the subcommittee. Mr. Gary Zhang, I remember at the time when we discussed the agenda items at the panel on welfare services, we discussed a public hearing for carers. Now that this subcommittee specifically set up for the purpose is in place, perhaps, Chair, you can discuss with the panel and see which should be tasked to hold this public hearing. I'd also like to be able to discuss the policy on child carers. At the moment, there isn't a lot of discussion as per the work plan as well. I think we can make up for this gap. Apart from community support and financial support, I'd also like to be able to discuss employment support or friendly measures at the workplace. So I support the member's suggestions. Right, point taken. We'll consider them. Next, Ms. Lam So Wai. Thank you, Chair. As mentioned by other members, as far as the existing policies go, there is support for carers of elderly as well as the disabled. But there are inadequacies in relation to support for carers of SEN children and those with special needs in terms of psychological and other support. We need to discuss that. We have two schemes, living allowance for carers of elderly persons and living allowance for low-income carers of persons with disabilities, but not other forms of living allowances. So I categorically propose living allowance for carers of ASEAN children. Second point in the work plan, we need to provide a definition for carers as well as collecting statistics. I propose setting up a database so as to provide a basis on which we can drive the development of carer-centric policies. The statistics will provide the necessary reference. Now, we may have a figure, some 400,000, 500,000 carers of elderly persons. What about carers of SEN children? We don't have the relevant statistics, so I propose setting up this database. Well, the 400,000 carers is in fact the number of people in the eyes of the government requiring care. And that is why on a one-to-one matching basis, we project that there are also 400,000 carers. We need to look after all carers.
Mr. Bill Tang, we can explore whether we deal with that at the panel. Well, in fact, this subcommittee is set up under the panel on welfare. So we focus on welfare. The panel. Now there will be a work report for this subcommittee. 12 months from now, we will compile a report on what we have worked on, the views we've listened to, changes we've been trying to drive, and outstanding work. We will cover them in the work report. So we can consider inviting deputations to come here for a hearing. That's the right way to go. That will help us to form a basis on why we're focusing on certain issues. Yesterday, another subcommittee was formed on residential services for children, child protection policies. Now, some members of the panel on welfare met with the representatives of some service units. They can have a more focused discussion at that subcommittee. And then 12 months from now, they compile the report. Those meetings, those interactions will form a solid basis for that work report. Now, coming back here, my only concern is that we have so much ground to cover. Now, I want to focus on one group, dementia. Now, just like frail seniors, dementia affects many seniors. And for people who have to care for people with dementia, from my experience in district work, I know these carers are confronted with huge stress. And there are many people in this category. So I wonder if we can cover support for carers looking after those with dementia. When I was in my first term as a legislative counselor, I pushed for collaboration between the medical community and also the social welfare department. First, the community care fund provided the funding, and then it was regularized. That approach went to show the sheer number of people that the policies in this area has a bearing on. So I wonder if we can make it a topic, or if we can get the government to provide us with information or provide a strategy on this area. Thank you, Mr. Bill Tank. So there are calls from members for a public hearing, as Mr. Bill Tank was saying. We can deal with some matters at this subcommittee. I will talk to the secretariat about this to see if we can make that happen. The members have mentioned various kinds of carers. We need to look for measures that can benefit all kinds of carers. And then for specific kinds of carers, say those looking after children with special education needs or those looking after people with dementia, and then we can leave that to a later point in time. Let's cover measures that will benefit all kinds of carers first. As Mr. Bill Tang was saying, we will compile a report on the work we've done in the end. Dr. Tik Chi Yun speaking for the second round. We have some time left, so I will let Dr. Tik speak for the second round. Chairman, for carers of children with SEN, now I am not too concerned about the sequence. It's just about the strategy. Can we put that into our work program? Many parents have expectations of us. If we leave SEN out, then I think some parents will not be happy. Now, on the public hearing, allow me to take up a bit more of your time. At the last meeting, Chairman, you said there would be a public hearing. The welfare sector became aware of it. I'm fine with doing a public hearing at this subcommittee, but let's try to avoid confusion for the sector. We need to be clear in our messaging. I hope the welfare panel can proceed with the public hearing, because the panel is larger than the subcommittee here that can avoid the confusion. But personally, I'm not too worried whether we should have the subcommittee or the panel do the public hearing. Mr. Bill Tang. I'm sure everyone will hold a meeting fairly and on the rules regarding speaking or attendance of public hearings, we follow the rules of the secretary. So it doesn't matter who's a chairman of a particular panel or subcommittee. I believe Dr. Tick's point is not about who's the chairman. The point is more like the kind of officials that will attend the public hearing. So, Chairman, let's work together on this. Let's work towards reassuring the deputation so that they will understand that their views will be noted by the committees, the panel, and the government. The members have made a variety of comments. The Secretariat will revise the work program or the work plan and then circulate the paper. I will talk to the government about the arrangements for our future meetings and the date. We will incorporate the comments made by members today. One member mentioned providing advice for the upcoming policy address. I will talk to the secretariat, and then the secretariat will issue a notice about the date of the next meeting. Fourth item on the agenda, any other business? Any other business from members? I don't have any myself. If there's no other business, I will adjourn the meeting here. Thank you.